أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي لا يبلغ مدحته القائلون ولا يحصي نعماه العادون ولا يؤدي حقه المجتهدون. الذي بعد فلا يرى وقرب فشهد النجوى تبارك وتعالى. والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين وشفيع المذنبين سيدنا ونبينا بالقاسم محمد. ولا أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. واللالة الدامة الباقية لأعدائهم ومنكر فضائلهم وغاصب حقوقهم من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين. أما بعد، فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: الله نور السماوات والأرض. صلوات عليك يا رب. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all for fulfilling the duty of expressing our love to the family of the Prophet. And one of the ways of doing that is to remember the members of the Ahlul Bayt in different occasions, whether it is happy or sad. This evening we have gathered to celebrate the birth anniversary of the lady who was the daughter of the Prophet of Islam, the wife of our first Imam, the mother of our second and third Imams, and the grandmother of the rest of our Imams. Normally, when we talk about her in English, we use a term that Fatima is the Lady of Light. Light means Nur. And keeping that perspective in mind, you know, this evening, very briefly, I would like to talk about the Ayat of Nur. Ayat of Nur is in Surah An-Nur. The surah itself is known as the Surah of Light. This is Surah number 24 of the Quran. In Ayat number 35, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about His light. It's a very symbolic ayat. Every word of this ayat cannot be taken in the literal sense. Every word has a symbolic meaning behind it. The ayat begins with the words, Allahu nuru samawati wal arz. Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth. What does it mean? When we say Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth, what does this first opening sentence of this ayat mean? This ayat is not talking about Allah. It's not describing Allah as the Nur. Because the Quran says very clearly, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. There is nothing comparable to Him. So Allah cannot even be compared to Nur. In Maha Ramadan and in different occasions, mu'mineen and mu'minat recite Dua-i Joshan-i Kabir. There you describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Munawwir al-Nur. Allah is the one who gives light to the light. Ya Khaliq al-Nur. Allah is the creator of the Nur and light. If Allah is creator of the Nur, Ya Mudabbir al-Nur, Allah is the one who manages the light. So this ayat which says Allah Nur al-Samawati wal-Arz cannot apply to the person of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a long ayat. At the end you will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the light that he's talking about is actually the light of guidance. Because the next word after Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Arz, are the words wa mathalu nurihi, and the example of his nur. So Allah is something else, his nur is something else. So this ayat is not talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here, nur basically means the nur of guidance, the light of guidance. And this is where I would like to look at the rest of the ayat, which is a very long ayat, full of symbolism. But I would like to have your attention in the name of Fatima Zahra, salawatullah alayha. Salawat. Look at the wordings. مَثَلُ نُورِهِ كَمِشْكَاتْ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٌ الْمِصْبَاحُ فِي زُجَاجَةٍ الزُجَاجَةٍ الزُجَاجَةَ كَأَنَّهَا كَوْكَبٍ دُرِّيٌّ. This is just half of the first part. The literal translation of this would be that the likeness or the example of his light is like the example of a niche which contains a lamp, and the lamp is inside a glass, and the glass is like a twinkling star. Did you understand anything? It's just symbolism. And we'll come to it. Every word of it needs, you know, reflection and explanation. Then the ayat goes on. يُوْقَدُ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ زَيْتُونِيَّةٍ. This lamp that Allah is talking about, which is in that niche, which is covered by a glass, and the glass which is, you know, like twinkling star, this lamp, يُوْقَد, it is lit by the oil from the blessed olive tree. لَا شَرْقِيَّةٍ وَلَا غَرْبِيَّةٍ. That tree is neither inclined towards the east nor to the west. يَكَادُ زَيْتُهَا يُضِيعُ وَلَوْ لَمْ تَمْسَسْهُ نَارٌ. And its oil almost gives light though it does not touch it. نُورٌ عَلَى نُورٌ. It is light upon light upon light. Salawat Quran Ekbar. Where does Fatima fit into this? Let us look at the ayat, you know, one word after another. It is totally an ayat which is based on what we call tamthilat, tashbihat, symbolism that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses in the Quran to describe his nur and his light of guidance. Look at the first word. He says, مَثَلَهُ مَثَلَ نُورِهِ كَمِشْكَاتِ. The example of his light is like Mishkat. What is Mishkat? Those who use this name for themselves, they should go and look into it. What does Mishkat mean? The translation of Mishkat is niche or niche, depending on British or North American pronunciation. Now these days we have niche in homes, you know, the recess in the wall to put decoration piece. But if you look at the older days, you know, niche had a very practical purpose in the house. Every room had that. They would basically make a niche in the wall, on the upper level of the wall, for a purpose. And the purpose was that that was a secure place in where you put the lamp when you didn't have electricity those days. And so Mishkat means that place where the lamp is placed. Why Mishkat is selected? Because it is a higher place. It's higher because when you put the lamp up, the light can reflect to all corners of the room. And it is in that, you know, the recess in the wall provides protection for it. So basically, Mishkat is a place which is secure for the lamp, for the light. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he looked at his Nur of guidance, he looked for a place where he can place that Nur. He was looking for a niche in a symbolic sense. He looked all around in the entire universe. He couldn't find any place in the universe more secure for his Nur than the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mishkat doesn't mean Mishkat. It's all symbolism here. Allah was looking for a secure place to put his Nur, his light of guidance, like a Mishkat, like a niche, and he found that in the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salawat alayhi. Once he found that the heart of Muhammad, that is that Mishkat, then Allah says, Fiha misbahun. Now that the Mishkat is found, Allah says, in that Mishkat, there is a Misbah. Misbah is a lamp. That's where you put the Mishkat is the place where you put the Misbah, the lamp. When you put the lamp, and here we are talking about the Nur of Hidayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in that Mishkat, there must be kind of compatibility between the place and the item. In medical science, when they do the transplantation of organs, they look at different factors. They have to make sure that, you know, the actual body accepts the foreign object. And so when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to put this misbah, this lamp, in the heart of Muhammad, he has to make sure the misbah and the heart of Muhammad are compatible to one another. And Allah asked Muhammad himself, who is closest to your heart? And the answer comes, Fatimatu baba'atum minni. Salawat pranay ikbala. Fatima tu bada'atum minni. Fatima is part of me. There can be nothing more compatible to the Prophet than Fatima. So you have that Mishkat, the niche, in form of the heart of Muhammad. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to put the misbah. That misbah, that lamp, is Fatima al-Zahra, salawatullah alayha. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on, al-misbah fi zujajatin, and the lamp is inside a glass. Az-zujaja is the glass. When you have a lamp and when you put it in the niche in the olden days, it had to be protected from wind. Otherwise, you know, the lamp will blow off. It wouldn't give any light anymore. And so normally what do? They put a glass on it, a protective glass. But when you put the glass on it, you have to make sure that the glass will protect. But the glass itself has to be clean and pure and transparent. Otherwise, you know, the whole purpose of protecting would be like extinguishing the light. The light wouldn't come out. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I was looking for a Mishkat I found in the heart of Muhammad. And once I found the Mishkat, I put the Misbah, the lamp of guidance, in there in form of Fatima. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I realized that this Nur has to be protected. Just like a lamp needs to be protected by the glass. But that glass should not only be a protective one, but also transparent. And so when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks around, he realizes, I don't have a choice but to find somebody who is a wali of Allah. And that is where the Zujaj comes in to protect that lamp in the heart of the Prophet, and that Zujaj and glass is Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wa salam. That is why we are told in the hadith that if there was no one like Ali, there would have been nobody comparable to Fatima in marriage. And it's interesting that we look at this, and this is not just, you know, personal views on this ayat. This is based on various ayat, ahadith, which have explained this ayat in different ways. I've just combined different ahadith to draw this conclusion that I'm presenting to you. And so Allah has given the nur of hidayat, the light of guidance. He's looking for a secure place for it, and he finds in the heart of Muhammad. And the misbah is placed in that, the lamp, and that lamp is in form of Fatima. In order to protect that lamp in the form of Fatima, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places a zujaj on it, the glass, and that is in form of Ali ibn Abi Talib. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes that glass. Don't ask me why he didn't talk about Mishkat, he didn't talk about Misbah. When he talks about Zujaj, he wants to explain now. What kind of Zujaj was that? Az-Zujaj ka'annahu kawkabun durri. That glass was like a twinkling star. And this is where you see the, I would call it, and I have to be very careful, this is the matter of aqidah, that I go, do not go beyond the limits. I see here interdependency between Ali and Fatima. Fatima is the lamp inside. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the nur of guidance. He's looking for a secure place, which he describes as mishkat, a niche. And that is the heart of Muhammad. And he places the misbah in it. This is a symbolic way of describing Fatima. In order to protect that misbah, Allah places a glass on it. And the glass is like a twinkling star. And then he described az-zujaj kanna kawkabun durri. And the point I was making at that time was the interdependency of Ali and Fatima. The glass by itself, without the lamp, would not have the reflection of light on it. The glass will only have this twinkling star effect if the light is shining on it. But the light cannot survive without the glass. Fatima needs Ali. Ali needs Fatima to Zahra. Salawat. On a symbolic way, يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونية لا شرقية ولا غربية. Allah is using the symbol of the lamp now. The lamp, for it to survive and give light, it needs oil. It needs source of power. And Allah uses the example here that this lamp is lit by شجرة مباركة زيتونية, by the blessed olive tree. Why olive tree? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say that this nur, this lamp which gives this nur, must come from the oil which is pure. And the most pure oil in dunya that Allah could, you know, give an example was the olive, oil from the olive. لا شرقية ولا غربية. Then he further describes this tree of olive. لا شرقية ولا غربية. The tree of olive is neither inclined towards east or the west. It means if it is in a garden which has four walls, the boundary walls, the tree is in the middle. It's not on the right or the left side or the west or the east. Because if the tree is by the wall, the sunlight will only come on some parts of the tree and not others. And if the light of the sun doesn't come fully, you know, it wouldn't get full energy. And the fruits of that tree would not have full color, taste, and smell. And so Allah says, this is a tree which is right there in the middle. And it is getting the light from the sun, from all directions. And that's where the purity of that oil comes from. And so, what is that energy source for this spiritual lamp? That is actually the revelation and wahi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salawat upon the Akbar. It is so pure that the light will be there all the time. As long as this dunya is there, that nur is going to be there. And this is where you can connect to this concept in Shia theology, where we talk about that al-ardu la yakhlu min hujjah, that the earth will never be without a hujjat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that hujjat, from Fatima onwards, from Fatima and Ali, will all be from the descendants of Fatima and Ali, alayhim salatu wa salam. Salawat upon the Akbar. Let me summarize the conclusion of this part of the ayat. The example of Allah's nur is like the niche, which is the heart of Muhammad. In that niche is a lamp, which is Fatima. And that lamp is in a glass, that is Ali. And the lamp is lit, and it survives by the source, which is divine revelation. Just one hadith. When I say that Mishkat is the heart of Muhammad, and Fatima is in the heart of Muhammad, just one hadith on this issue, where Amir al-Mu'mineen himself describes the relationship of the Panjatan to one another, rather the relationship of the four to one, to Rasul. And he says, "Inna al-Hasan wal-Husayn, huma min Muhammad kamakan al-Ainain." Hasan and Husayn, in relation to Rasulullah, they are like the two eyes on the head. Wa amma ana, my relationship to Rasul, فَكَمَا مَكَانَ الْيَدْ مِنَ الْبَدَنِ, I am the arm of Rasul. The arm is there to protect the body. وَأَمَّا الْفَاطِمَةَ فَكَمَكَانِ الْقَلْبِ مِنَ الْجَسَدِ. And the relationship of Fatima to Rasulullah is the relationship of the heart to the body. Salawat Quran Ekbar. There is a lot more to say about it. The ayat ends with the words Nurun ala Nur. The literal translation is light upon light. This will never be extinguished. This will be there, not only in this dunya, but even in akhirah. All other light will end. You look at the ayat about Qiyamah. The moon is there, the sun is there, the stars are there, but everything will be shut off. But in the day of Qiyamah, when the mu'mineen are taken towards the Jannah, on the day of Mahshar, and the munafiqeen are going towards Jahannam, there are ayat of Quran where they will say to the mu'mineen, can you let us borrow the light which is showing you the way? This light is not only for dunya. This is a light, if you hold on to it, it will show us the way, all the way to the Jannah, inshallah. Salawat upon the Ikbar. And so from that nur, you will have nur after nur. You can have one nur after another nur. A wali after wali, and an imam after imam. कुछ उर्दू के लिए भी छोड़ना है वरना हमारे बुजुर्ग नाराज़ हो जाएंगे. खुदावंद आलम ने सूरह नूर में आयत नूर में जो मिसाल दी है तशबीहात की बुनियाद पर, उस मिसाल में खुदावंद आलम ने यह कहा है कि मेरा नूर, खुदा का नूर फिज़िकल सेंस में नहीं है, नूर हिदायत की बात हो रही है. खुदावंद आलम ने एक ताक में करार दिया जो कल्ब मोहम्मद है, और उस ताक में खुदावंद आलम ने एक चिराग रखा जो फातिमा की शक्ल में है. उस चिराग की हिफाजत के लिए खुदावंद आलम ने जुजाज एक फानूस रखा जो ग्लास है, और वो फानूस बेशकल अली है. अब यहाँ से एक बात जो हमने अंग्रेज़ी में नहीं की थी, और जो बुज़ुर्ग जो समझते हैं अपने बच्चों को समझा दें गाड़ी में घर जाते हुए, ये जो फानूस है, जो ग्लास है लैंप में होता है, कभी कभी गोल होता है, सिर्फ सर्कुलर होता है, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द डिज़ाइनर. कभी कभी वो ग्लास बनाने वाले को जो है ज़्यादा क्रिएटिव होता है, वो कहता है हम इसको गोल नहीं बनाएंगे, इसमें मुख्तलिफ पैनल्स बनाएंगे. तो वो जो फानूस है उस चिराग पर जो कल्ब मोहम्मद में है, जिसने इस फानूस को बनाया है उसने चाहा कि उसको गोल ना बनाए. अल्लाह भी डाइवर्सिटी चाहता है, क्रिएटिविटी चाहता है, इंसानों को भी एक शक्ल में नहीं बनाया है. कोई गोरा है, कोई काला है, कोई दरमियानी है, कोई लंबा है, कोई पस्त है. तो खुदावंद आलम ने भी उस फानूस को देखा है कि भाई ये गोल जो है तो बहुत ही आम बात है, उसमें उसने जो है पैनल्स लगाए. अब हमारे ये तखयल की बात है, वो पैनल्स इस टाइप के थे कि वो दर हकीकत 12 पैनल्स होते हैं. नूरुन अला नूर, एक नूर के बाद दूसरा नूर, एक इमाम के बाद दूसरा इमाम, एक वली के बाद दूसरा वली. वो सिलसिला ख़त्म होने वाला नहीं है. नूर उन अला नूर, अली के बाद हसन, हसन के बाद हुसैन, फिर अली आएंगे, फिर मोहम्मद आएंगे, फिर जाफर आएंगे, फिर काजिम आएंगे, फिर रज़ा आएंगे, फिर रज़ा के बाद फिर मोहम्मद आएंगे, फिर अली आएंगे, फिर हसन आएंगे, और आखिर में मेहदी आखिर जमान आएंगे. सलावात. लेकिन इस नूर में, इस सिलसिले नूर में जो रंग है, चूंकि खुदा ने भी सिंबल बात की है तो हम भी सिंबल पे ख़त्म मत करते हैं, कि इस सिलसिले नूर में आइम्मा के जो है अगर आपको उसमें रंग देखना हो, खुशबू देखना हो, तो ये रंग और खुशबू फातिमा से आ रही। जब आप इन आइम्मा को देखते हैं, हसन के हिल्म को देखा, हुसैन की शुजात को देखा, सज्जाद की इबादत को देखा, बाकिर की काविशों को देखा, जाफर के आसार को देखा, काजिम के उलूम को देखा, रज़ा के दलील और बराहीन को देखा, तकी के वजूद और सखा को देखा, नकी की पाकिजगी और तहारत को देखा, अस्करी की हैबत को देखा और मेहदी की गैबत को आप देखते हैं, यह सब असर है उस नूर का जिसका नाम फातिमतु ज़हरा है। सलावात पढ़ें। फातिमा सिर्फ रसूल की बेटी नहीं है, सिर्फ अली की जौजा नहीं है, सिर्फ हसन और हुसैन की वालदा नहीं है, बकिया तमाम आइम्मा के जद्दा सिर्फ नहीं है, बल्कि ये वो चिराग और नूर हैं जिसको खुदावंद आलम ने कल्ब मोहम्मद में करार दिया है। उसी मुतबर्रिक नाम से दुआ करते हैं, खुदावंदा अल्लाहुम्मा इन्नी नसअलुका बिहक फातिमा व अबीहा व बालिहा व बनीहा व तिसअतिल मासूमीन मिन ज़ुर्रियतिहा। खुदावंदा हमारी इस कलियबात कबूल फरमा, हमारे गुनाहों को बख्श दे, हमारी तौफीकात में इजाफा फरमा। खुदावंदा जिस दौर से ये कम्युनिटी गुजर रही है, खुदावंदा इस कौम को, इस कम्युनिटी को अपने हिफ्ज़ अमान में रख, दुश्मनों के नज़र को हमसे दूर रख और इनके शर को हमसे दूर फरमा। इमाम के ज़ुहूर में ताजील फरमा। रब्बना तकब्बल मिन्ना इन्नका अंतस समीउल अलीम।